Can you hear that?
No?
Allow me to bump the levels. How about now? You see, you might not realize it, but most microphones, like the one we have mounted above me, will pick up some audible hum from the room they're in, whether it's mechanical sounds, air conditioning, or forced air. Microphones are really good at picking up noises of all kind. Today, we're going to talk about how to remove those noises after the fact and get your audio right every time. Before we begin, it's important to note that this technique works best when done before you have made any cuts or alterations to your footage. This way, you can apply the effect to the entire audio clip instead of having it for each individual cut. With our footage and audio loaded and synced into Adobe Premiere Pro, we'll right-click on the audio track and select Edit in Adobe Audition. We'll then wait for the program to open. Immediately, our audio file will pop up in the editor and we can begin the cleanup process. The first step is to capture the noise print. This is basically a short sample of the noise you wish to remove from the clip. In our case, a great sample is at the very beginning. We'll use the zoom in tool to zoom in on the beginning where our cursor is and select our desired part. Once you've selected a part where your speaker isn't talking, play it through just to make sure no other sounds occur. Once we have selected our desired noise, we'll go up to the Effects tab, under Noise Reduction Restoration, and then click Capture Noise Print. A dialog box will open saying that the program has captured and analyzed the noise print. Click OK. We'll then go back to Effects, under Noise Reduction Restoration, and click Noise Reduction Process. We'll make sure our noise reduction is around 80% for our first try and hit Apply. You can now see that some of the waveforms when the speaker isn't talking have been deleted. You can now listen through your footage to see what it sounds like. If the clip sounds too tinny, you can always hit undo and go back and reduce the amount of noise reduction. Less noise reduction usually results in a more natural sounding piece. However, more background noise will be present. Once we have a result that we're happy with, we'll hit File and Save. Now the file has been updated in Premiere Pro. You can now close Adobe Audition. Back in Premiere, you can see that the audio file flashed and refreshed. This means that the audio has been updated. We can now add an EQ effect to our updated audio to add a more natural sound. Under the Effects tab, we'll type in EQ and drag it onto our audio. We'll then go up under the Audio Effects and hit Edit. What I usually like to do is boost the lows and the highs to add a more natural sound. This will add some of the bass back from when we reduce the audio. Play around in the EQ to get a result that you like. Once you're happy with your result, you can close the dialog box. With that complete, you can begin the editing process with high quality audio.